Hello, and thank you for tuning in. You are tuned into Esoteric Guidance, and my name is Nehru. We are going to go ahead and get started, or get going, on part three of recognizing divine masculine, divine feminine synchronicities. And actually, we're going to speak today about manifesting our divine masculine and divine feminine. And then obviously the karmic side of things. Okay, so again, recognizing the manifesting, and I'm going to hopefully help us to see and tap into kind of some Akashic records. Okay, and for those of you who are not familiar with Akashic records are they are your spiritual journal. Okay, they are your spiritual map. Okay, and so if you want to know more about your previous lives here on this planet and elsewhere, you need to tap into your Akashic records. You can't do that by any other means other than your chakras being activated and you being in your north node. Okay, you can't do that any other way. Okay, you can't do that by using hallucinogens. You can't do it by those means. Okay, from time to time, I like to smoke a little something. It's been a while since I've smoked a little something, and I can tell you that my esoteric travel hasn't stopped. Okay, so you don't need that in order to, right? So you don't need any earthly substance. It's all within. Again, the 33 vertebrae that flow up and down your that make up your spinal cord, okay? There's fluid on both sides, okay? Both sides. That fluid is Christos, okay? This is proven. That fluid that flows up and down from your pineal gland down to your tailbone or your root chakra, it flows up actually, is the Christ within you. Okay, so Christ is literally, the Christos is literally within you. So when it says the kingdom of God is within you, it's literally within your physical body. Okay, you need to activate that. You do pineal gland activations and 369 frequency. I would listen to those, okay, to help that. Okay. So again, thank you so much, subscribers, for tuning in. We have in the last 24 hours picked up several new subscribers, so thank you and welcome aboard. In the What's Your Aura video, I made mention of the three new subscribers that I am aware of. I don't always get the name notifications for our subscribers. But when I do, I like to mention them on the channel. Okay. And so those are OG Monk, Brian, and Melchizedek. Okay. So there might be something about any of those names. Obviously, Melchizedek is significant for spiritual, you know, for canonical text reasons. Okay. And maybe Mont is too. I don't know. Brian may be a name that you're familiar with this lifetime. All right. So, how do we go about manifesting our divine masculine or divine feminine? And I didn't do this yesterday, so let me go ahead and clarify for our new subscribers. Anyone, male or female, can be a divine masculine, can be a masculine or a feminine. You get divine status, again, when you're operating in your north node, you are functioning in your highest, purest, truest self. You are functioning authentically, is a better way to put it, okay? Right? And so when you are functioning authentically, you don't care what other people think. You don't care what they say. And speaking of which, I had a comment this morning on the video, on the Book of Jubilees video that was posted yesterday, and the individual was a gaslighter, You know, you recognize them, right? You recognize them, okay? They said, the sun is not 90 plus million miles away. So here you go, fuckwad. Let's find out how far the sun is from the Earth. Alexa, how far is the sun from Earth?
The sun is 92.94 million miles from Earth.
Okay. So that's for you, gaslighter. You didn't gaslight me. And I responded and I said, it's 92.94 million miles away. That's what I put in that comment. Anyone listening to this video can go on there and see their comment and see my reply. It's not ugly, it's not nasty, okay? But here's my nonverbal communication to you. All right? Okay? Find something else better to do than trying to gaslight people, okay? You're wasting your time, okay? Okay, me and my Sagittarian energy with my arrows, okay, and shoot that shit down quick and in a heartbeat. All right. So, manifesting your divine masculine. So any male or female can be functioning in their masculine or feminine energy. Again, the confusion with lesbianism and homosexuality is they do not manage this energy well, okay? So you might be a man. I am a man. I am a male this lifetime, okay? And again, it's what you were born as. Anything that science does or medical whatever operations and all that, that's fake shit. It's no different than the silicone they pump into ass, lips, cheeks, titties, whatever. It's no different than any of that, okay? The highest divine white light doesn't make any mistakes. When he made man, he said that it is good. When he created the earth, he said it is good. Man has their hand in way too much of what highest divine white light has called good since the beginning of creation in this space. Okay? So man puts things in the sky to make it rain. Man controls what grows and the animals that produce the things that we consume. So pumps the egg, the chickens full of steroids, pumps the whatever, cows and so on and so forth, right? Trying to make better what highest divine white light is already called good. He called you good when you were born, male or female, in any given, in whatever given lifetime, okay? Changing your dick for a vagina or your vagina for a dick, you are messing up what highest divine white light has created, his perfection, okay? All right, you're messing it up, okay? I am a male with a penis, and I am a divine feminine, okay? Recognize this. You might be a female, but function in divine masculine energy. So let's go ahead and talk about this real quick. It's 8:23 Mountain Standard Time and 83 degrees. 8:23 and 83 degrees, okay? By the way, for those of you who are new subscribers, the reason why I have my shirt off is because I am in an RV where I've been for 11 months. 8-4 will be 5 months, or be 12 months, something about 5 months. 8-4 will be, will be 12 months, okay, that I've been here after I gave everything that I owned away, because that's what I was guided to do by highest divine white light. I woke up one day, the country song, Just Give It Away. Just give it away. There ain't nothing in this house worth fighting over. And we're both tired of fighting anyway. Just give it away. Right? I love country music. Love country music. Right? So, being a divine masculine, if you are a female, doesn't mean you're a dyke. It doesn't mean you're a lesbian. And again, this energy gets confused. Okay? Right? So you end up being a Lady Gaga or a Candace Parker. Okay? You end up being a Jada Pinkett Smith. Right? Who licks and sucks things simultaneously or whatever they do, her and Will Smith, the nasty ass sacral energy, whatever it is their lifestyle is, polygamous, polyamorous, swingers, whatever. Okay? So, don't get those energies confused, okay? And don't fall into that just because you are. So what's the difference between the operating of a divine masculine and a divine feminine? Okay? So a divine masculine is gifted with the ability for earthly wealth. They are entrepreneurs. That's not to say divine feminines are not. But again, their main focus, what they bring to the table as a divine masculine, is their physical worth ethic. Just like a male, born that way, a male brings the strong back to tilling the ground, as we are commanded to do as men. Okay? Same thing. Spiritually, again, everything that is above is below. Okay? Everything. Okay? So, with a divine masculine energy, again, you can be a female. You are a go-getter. You are a boss lady. You are a not a diva. A diva is a negative thing. Okay? Or at least in my eyes it is. Okay? I don't want a diva. I wouldn't marry a diva. I'm not interested in that. Okay? I am interested in my divine masculine. Okay? And when you are a divine feminine, okay, you are a nurturer. You are highly connected. And again, not to say the masculine is, but your focus is the esoteric, is the spiritual. So here's the balance. Here's the balance, people. Okay, the divine masculine brings the earthly wealth. The divine feminine brings the spiritual wealth. Again, that's not to say they still have to be their authentic selves and work out their own salvation with fear and trembling individually. They still have to do that. But coming together and focus and being their highest, truest, purest form, that is what they bring. Okay? They are gifted with the entrepreneurial, again, spirit. They are very creative in earthly things, creating wealth, businesses, serial entrepreneurs, and things of that nature. Okay? Elon Musk might be a divine feminine. Okay? So, and Bill Gates, and right, so these people might be, okay? Alexander Graham Bell. Is that his name? Might have been a divine, divine masculine. Might have been a divine masculine with all of the inventions and all of that sort of thing, right? And so on and so forth, okay? Nikola Tesla is a divine feminine. Okay? Neville Goddard is a divine feminine. Okay? So recognizing who you are when you're in your highest, purest, truest form is essential. Essential to not crossing. What do they call it in Ghostbusters? They call it crossing the streams. That's what happens when people get confused and women end up licking clits and men end up sucking dicks. You're crossing the streams. Don't cross the streams. Don't cross the streams. It's dangerous. Don't cross the streams. Right? So that's the difference between divine masculines, divine feminines, and what their aura and what they bring to the table in a divine relationship, that is, or divine union. That is what they bring. That is the large source of what they bring. Okay? So often divine feminines, you may be a little ahead spiritually in your knowledge and your wisdom than your divine masculine. Again, they are divine as well. Okay? You just spend more time focused on it than they do. Their focus, and it's meant this way, their focus is the natural thing. Okay? Again, that doesn't mean you both can't be business owners. That doesn't mean any of that. Okay? That doesn't mean one can be a lazy ass and stay at home and not work. That's not what that means. Okay? So manifesting your divine feminine and divine masculine. Also, I thought of another... No, I won't mention that. Anyway, I was going to say something about synchronicity, but it's not pertinent for it right now. So, it's 8:30 and 83 degrees outside. 8:30. 83. 11:11. I wasn't going to say it, so now it's 3:11. So now I recognized another synchronicity yesterday after posting that video about divine masculine, divine feminine, and versus karmic synchronicities. I went into the military. My enlistment date was 3/29. Okay? That was 1995. 3/29. Okay? That breaks down to 3/11. Okay? I wasn't going to mention it, but it's 83 degrees and 8:30, which is an 11. It's 11/11, actually. So, anyway, that might be significant for you, or you might be a Scorpio or dealing with one. Okay? So how do we go about manifesting our divine masculine or divine feminine, depending on what is applicable? Okay? Again, if you do not know which one you are, I encourage you to look up more videos on YouTube and do your own due diligence to find out how to determine what you function in your true authentic self. Okay? Okay? My true authentic self is extremely artistic. I was thinking about yesterday, my battle buddy from Germany, my roommate, his name is, I don't even know if I remember his last name now, because after the military, I got so used to calling him Drew. His name's Andrew. I got so used to calling him Drew. I don't even remember his last name, which is highly unusual for me, highly unusual. Given the military, that's what they call you. They call you by your last name. But anyway, his name is, we call him Drew. He lives in Tampa, Florida, by the way. He had a bass guitar, and I taught myself how to play. He helped me, but I learned how to play the bass guitar, the electric bass guitar, while I was in Germany. Okay, so I'm very artistic. Acrylic painting, oil painting. Yeah, I can also change the engine in a car. Okay, so it's again a balance. It's a balance. I can be in masculine energy just as well. And for those of you who've been a part of this channel, you know for sure that you've seen me in masculine energy. When I got pissed off at whatever was going on, the energy attacks, realizing what was being done to me by individuals that I had given unconditional love to, you have seen me at times in a strong, very strong masculine energy, okay? And so, yeah, all right? So let's talk about this. So I want you to think back. Think back to your dreams, and not your literal dreams. Think back to your hopes, okay, men and women? Think back to your hopes. The dreams, perhaps, that you've never shared with anyone. I want you to think about the dreams that repeat themselves. Think about the dreams that repeat themselves. Okay? I'm going to give you an example, of course, of myself, because that's the best example. Okay? By the way, the RV that I'm in, for our new subscribers, is in Arizona. It's in southern Arizona. So we know what the temperature is like in southern Arizona in July. So that's the reason why I have my shirt off. Only one of the air conditioners in this RV is working. The RV is probably a late 70s, early 80s model RV. Okay. Thankfully, otherwise I would have ended up with my head in the dirt. Okay. I would have ended up homeless for the fourth time. I've been homeless three times. Two of those times was while I was on dialysis. Okay. I've walked this journey a long time by myself. Okay, and that's not a, yeah, that's just to relate to you that maybe you have too, okay? I laced them up myself again, time and time again. I've laced them up myself, okay, and got back out there. So there is one particular dream that I, or vision, it could be a vision too, by the way, that I've had repeatedly. And there's a couple of them, but I'm going to share this one. I don't want to give too much information away. I'm going to share this one, again, just because of karmic energy that watches the channel, okay? But we, her and I, we are in this vehicle, and we pull up to this house. And it's one of those, it's not a Spanish-style house, I don't believe. I'm trying to think of the type of architecture. I'm not very familiar with types of architecture when it comes to homes and things. I like homes. Again, if I didn't go into the military, I would be a luxury home seller. I would work for Sotheby's or Christie's Estates or something like that. That is one of those kind of off to the side kind of dreams of mine, you know, that I would have done. I would have definitely, I like real estate. I like that. I like the elegance. I like I like that, you know, sweeping staircases, and I love that, okay? And I could very much see myself working with high-end buyers, and helping them find their next dream home, vacation home, what have you, okay? Estate, right? And again, some of that might resonate with you. Oh, another synchronicity are eights. I didn't mention eights, by the way. So the Scorpio and I are 16 days apart the same year. Okay, that's an eight and an eight. Okay? Military, 8 years. Okay? Eights. Eights might be significant for you. It's 836. Okay? So, anyway, in this dream, we pull up to this house in this car. Her and I are in the back of the car. Chauffeur gets out. Well, I get out. And then the chauffeur gets out. He goes to her side, which is on the curb side, opens the door. I walk around. And we hold hands as we're walking away. And at one point, it's kind of like a freeze frame. And she's wearing this sequined red dress, okay? Black hair, okay? She is of this color, not this color, okay? Or this color, not this color, okay? No one's this color, no one's black, and no one's this color. No one's white. That is a demonic, racism, systemic thing that man has planted since Niger of Cyrene. Look it up. Niger of Cyrene. Look it up. Look it up. Look it up. Okay? So, and I don't even use, again, for our new subscribers, I don't use black and white. I don't use those terms. Okay? I am a brown man. I am a brown American. I'm not even African American, okay? Despite my Egyptian shamanic ancestry, I am not African American. I am a brown American. I am more American than some Caucasian Americans. I fought 8 years for this country. You can't get much more American than being a fighter for freedom for it, can you? Maybe being president. Maybe even that is not more. Because some of them dodged the military. Need I mention names? Right? So some of them avoided the military. Okay? I'm a brown American. And then we hold hands and we walk up this staircase to this large house, to this event, wherever it is. Okay? That's one vision that I've had repeatedly. 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 Okay? I don't know who she is. I don't know where she is. I don't know her name. I am certain she's aware of me, however. Okay, today, right now. Okay, so yours may or may not be aware of you. Okay, so I want you to go back and think about the dreams that you've had repeated about this man or woman in your life. And then you need to determine if you are with someone, whether or not, I keep looking at this thing, at Echo, right, to see if there's anything that speaks out as these pictures change and notifications and all that sort of thing that I need to mention. That's why I keep looking over here. So, if that person does not resemble who you are currently with, you need to leave, okay? Because here's what you're doing if you are connected to or committed to someone who is really, truly not your divine masculine or divine feminine, whichever is applicable. You are not only keeping yourself from your divine masculine or feminine, you are keeping them from their divine masculine or divine feminine. So you are both functioning in your south nodes, your lower energy, shallow energy, okay, dark energy, shadow energy, shallow and shadow energy, okay? You need to release them. Don't wait for them to release you. Don't talk to me about kids. I will leave a woman in a heartbeat and still have a relationship with the child, if, or in my case, I have two adult daughters, okay? If they choose still to have a relationship with me, they can reach out to me or reconnect with me if they choose to, okay? I will never stay with a woman for the kids. Confirmation with the motorcycle start. Confirmation, can you hear it? I will never stay with a woman for kids, ever. I have to be in love with and passionate about the woman who was laying next to me. I have to be. Because I'm not dragging myself down in order to stay with someone for the sake of children. I will never do that. And you should never do that. That's why they have a legal system. It's not a justice system. I grant that, okay? It's a legal system. Injustices happen all the time through that man-made system, all the time. Okay? So, divine masculine, understand that if it should ever come down to it, okay, and authenticity is lost or one falls off the wagon, understand that I will not stick around. Whoever you are, divine masculine, understand that. I will leave you, okay? I don't believe I have to worry about that with this union coming forward, because this is the union that's written in the Akashic Records, okay? And this is the replacement for the past relationship that did fall off the wagon or refuse to heal or whatever, and that might be your situation. Okay? You might be with someone who refuses to heal themselves, so they won't get off the addiction, they won't stop the polygamous or polyamorous whatevers, okay? That person has turned karmic for you, okay? It's no different than buying fruit today that's fresh, waiting till it spoils, and then consuming it. That fruit has run its course. Why are you trying to consume that? You need to throw that out. Take out the trash. That trash. Okay? If that means you leaving or them leaving, however it needs to happen. Okay? All right. So, getting back to realizing the things that have been repeated dreams or visions for you. Think on those things today. Think on those things. Who have you seen constantly in your dream? What's that image? Okay? YouTube. Or Alexa. YouTube.
Here is YouTube.
I'm going to share with us a couple of song downloads, if you don't mind. Okay? Confirmation, I am okay. So I need to go ahead and do that confirmation burp. I haven't had anything to eat today. And only a cup of water so far. Confirmation burp again. Okay, so I'm going to do this. All right. So give me just one moment while I find this. Okay, and it's two songs. Okay? And this is a way that you can go about manifesting your divine masculine or your divine feminine, everyone. Okay? So, music. Okay, yesterday when I got done with the download with part two, I received two songs that afternoon. Okay? One is by Rod Stewart. He has a great voice. Him, Kenny Perry, there are a lot of great male vocalists and all that. Who was the lead singer for 38 Special? Whoever that is, great, great voice. So anyway, Rod Stewart, okay? This song, I consider myself a ballad singer. I could sing good love ballads. For whatever reason, I think because that's just my energy. I am a romantic. I will send you flowers. I will send you gifts or whatever any day, go shopping for you, buy you something to wear, whatever, any day. I'm just like that. So Rod Stewart song, Have I Told You Lately That I Love You? Okay. Have I told you lately that I love you? Have I told you there's no one else above you? You fill my heart with gladness, take away all my sadness, ease my troubles, that's what you do. For the morning sun in all its glory greets the day with hope and comfort too. You fill my life with laughter, and somehow you make it better. Ease my troubles, that's what you do. There's a love that's divine. My tune is off. And it's yours and it's mine, like the sun. And at the end of the day, we should give thanks and pray to the one, that's highest divine white light, to the one. Have I told you lately that I love you? Okay, so that's one song, all right? Here's the other song. Okay, it's by Joe Cocker and Jennifer Warnes. Okay, it's Love Lift Us Up Where We Belong. Okay, and I'm again just gonna sing talk part of the words. Okay. Who knows what tomorrow brings? In a world, few hearts survive. All I know is the way I feel. When it's real, I keep it alive. The road is long. There are mountains in our way, but we climb a step every day. Love lift us up where we belong, where the eagles cry on a mountain high. Love lift us up where we belong, far from the world below. That's the karmic energy, the world below, where the clear winds blow up here. Okay, all right. So Yeah. All right. Again, I'm a love. I was gonna say Love Ballad. That's a song. Alexa, Love Ballad by LTD. Alexa, Love Ballad by LTD.
Here's what I found.
So, these are the songs that I think my, these are the kinds of songs my voice is better suited for. All right. So again, how do you manifest your divine masculine or divine feminine? Okay, you take that image that you receive, okay, and you use it. Okay. I haven't heard this song before. Voice again is more suited for those types of songs, and some country. So this is a way, okay, singing these types of songs, listening to these types of songs, and thinking about them. Where if you have an image in your head, so I don't know exactly what the face of my divine masculine looks like, okay, however, okay, I can still imagine them dancing with them, walking with them, or what have you, singing to them. I can still imagine these things, okay? When you are meditating, okay, think on these things. Think on how you would like your wedding to be. Think on the, think about the wedding rehearsal. You know, think about the first dance together on the dance floor at your wedding. Think about where you would like to travel with them. Think about these things and you two doing these things. This helps you to manifest them, him or her, okay? And so another way that you can manifest or go about manifesting this individual, again, is to keep a journal. Okay? Right? And you can write down these visions, these dreams, okay? Also, you could use a vision board. I haven't had a vision board in a while. But you can have a vision board, okay? And this vision board can help you, okay? So, cut out pictures of men or of women that look similar to the visions that you've seen of your divine masculine or your divine feminine. Okay? Also, I'm going to take this down a different road, okay, here for a moment, as Highest Divine White Light is giving this to me. Before you meet your divine masculine or divine feminine, you need to be celibate for a time. That might be difficult for you. That might be more difficult than manifesting or meditating about them or on their union, okay? You need to be celibate, okay? All right, again, new subscribers, I am on my third stint of celibacy and I am on year two. I've last known a woman intimately, 2022, okay? So, celibacy, Okay? Also, from time to time, you need to practice sexual fluid retention. Okay, again, I don't want to ask Alexa that question. I don't want to ask that. But whatever that is for women, I don't know. Whatever women's secretions or whatever that is, I don't know what that is. So, and men, semen retention, okay? You need to practice this in order to, first of all, clear your sacral energy. That sacral energy is located right below your belly button, okay? That sacral energy controls your creativity, okay? So if you're stagnant in your creativity and you are very sexually active, that might be a reason why. Okay? So celibacy, before you meet your divine masculine or divine feminine. What I have discovered in looking and observing other relationships, I am generally not one that goes from one relationship right into the next. I did do that. And one particular case over the last 10 years, but generally that's not me. I don't generally do that. I take time off, and I did this even before my dark night of the soul. I do this because I've just never been like that. I don't know. That just seems like a player energy to me, right? Today I'm with Lisa, Keisha, Christina, Yolanda, whatever that song is. Whatever that song is, okay? And I've realized, like Dr. Dre said, so you found you a hoe that you like, but you can't make a hoe a housewife, right? And so take time for yourself, men and women. Take time for yourself to cleanse your energy, clear your aura. Your heart chakra needs to be cleared out, okay, from the previous relationship. So not just celibacy sexually, your heart needs to be cleared out, okay? Your heart chakra needs to be cleared out for this new divine energy to come in, okay? Have you ever seen the show Hoarders? Would any of you go live with any of those people who are hoarders? Would any of you go, that was my neighbor walking by, I was just looking to see what image that was out of my peripheral. Would any of you go live with a hoarder? They are something of a hoarder, by the way. But that's them. This is where Highest Divine White Light has placed me. I'm between addresses 444 and 333. Okay, that is exactly where I am located, where this address that I am at is located, between those two addresses. Okay? Divine, just highest divine white light and ancestors guiding all the way. If we are willing to pay attention and willing to do the work that we need to do, okay? And then allow them to do the things that they need to do. So I've been sitting here for 11 months and then working on myself, right? Again, becoming more, tapping into more Akashic records, becoming more wise, becoming sharing more on the channel, right? And all that sort of thing, okay? And clearing out my energy, okay? Again, it's been 2 years, but still clearing out energy. Heart, mainly heart chakra for me, heart chakra, okay? So, would you ever want to live, or would you ever voluntarily walk into that house of that hoarder and be like, oh yeah, make yourself at home happily? I should hope not. But when you do not clear out your energy before going into another relationship, that is what you are doing, or that is what you are inviting them into your spiritual horridness. Horridness, does that mean whore? I don't know. Or hoarderness. Okay? Clean that stuff out. Okay? Clean it out. Okay? Also, solar plexus energy. Okay? The previous relationship might have damaged your confidence, or you might be bitter or angry or whatever else. Okay? Right? Don't go out there looking for a rebound, man or woman. Don't go out there looking for that, because that's just bringing more junk into your house. Okay, that's not taking the trash out. You're just becoming a bigger spiritual hoarder, energetic hoarder. Okay? So, these are ways and means by which we can manifest our divine feminine or divine masculine. I can tell you for a fact that if you are an energetic hoarder right now, so you have nasty sacral energy, you have, and when I say nasty, just hasn't been cleaned out, it hasn't been purified, hasn't been, maybe it's not even activated, okay? All right? So if your legs are open yesterday and you broke up that relationship, or you separated from them last week, last month, you know, 2-3 months ago, okay? And you are jumping right into another relationship, or you started another relationship, this is a good one, you started another relationship while you were in that other previous relationship that ended. I'm going to say something. Every human being, every body, every spiritual human spiritual being in the flesh on this planet that you have sexual intercourse with, that is a spiritual union. And in order for you to meet your divine masculine, I feel like I need to look up here for this. In order for you to meet your divine masculine or divine feminine, you cannot be energetically married to anyone else. Nobody else. That's spiritual polygamy. Nobody else. That's spiritual polyamorous relationships. Okay? Polyamorous relationships are women who have multiple men at the same time, and polygamists are men who have multiple women at the same time. Again, new subscribers, I was born into a polygamous family. That is, again, why, including the siblings that are not from the sperm donor, I have there's a total of 18 of us. Okay, 18 of us. Okay? All right. So, make sure if there's anything else. I don't believe so. Let's take a look and see. Let's pull a couple of tarot cards. Okay. And yeah, let's check on our energy today. Okay. Again, I'm good, happy. And the way that things are going for me and the signs and synchronicities that I am receiving, I hope you are feeling the same. It is 47:40 on the clock on the video timer. Alexa, what time is it?
The time is 9:02 a.m.
Oh, I turned the volume down. Hold on 1 second. Alexa, what time is it?
The time is 9:02 a.m.
Okay, 9:02. Alexa, what's the temperature?
Right now, it's 88 degrees Fahrenheit. Today, expect a high of 96 degrees.
Oh wow, it's only going to be 96 degrees today. I'd be surprised if that actually is true. That's amazing. But again, we did have a lot of rain overnight, so I'm sure that cooled the atmosphere over Arizona down a little bit. But it's still, you know, it'll still be 85 degrees in the RV when it's 96 degrees outside. Okay? So yesterday was extremely hot. Yesterday, my phone read at 1.107. 107. That was probably the fourth or fifth day this year, this month, that it's been 107 degrees. It was hot yesterday. Hot. Okay? So I was happy for the rain. Okay? Again, subscribers, returning listeners, I hope you're doing well. Yeah, I hope you love where you are. I hope you love where you are today. Physically and esoterically, I hope you love where you are. Okay? Manifesting your highest divine white light, divine masculine, divine feminine, is easy when you remove the trash. Okay? It's easy when you remove the trash. Okay? Thank you, highest divine white light universe. Thank you for your faithfulness. Ancestors, Horus, thank you. And we have 3. Okay. Okay. So we have the Knight of Cups. This card is rather beat up. We have the Knight of Cups, the Nine of Wands, and we have the Eight of Cups. All of these cards here, all three of these, speaks to a readiness. Look at that. That's what that energy says to me today. All of this speaks to a readiness. You see that? All of that speaks to a readiness. Look at the stability of this horse, okay? In most cases, if you see the Knight of Wands or the Knight of Swords, those horses in that image, they're moving very fast, okay? And this, it's a very calm energy. That's where we are, collective. That's where we are, divine masculines and divine feminines. A calm energy. This is also the divine masculine or feminine coming towards us. This can be their energy. Very calm, very relaxed, steady, steadfast. All of this speaks to a readiness. All of this speaks to this, okay? The Eight of Cups is behind her, okay? They are protected, okay? All eight cups. Okay, she's guarding this. Very calm, energetic. Red might be significant. We are learning about the red aura and what that energy is in our What's Your Aura series. Okay? And so then we have the Knight of Wands. Okay? Again, this speaks to protection. Protection over our union. Okay? That's coming in, or that you are currently in. If you are currently in it, okay, then congratulations. Okay? Ooh, there's a song that comes to mind, Congratulations. And it's that song, Congratulations, is about, I believe, a woman who missed the opportunity with someone who went on to get married. I believe that's what that song is about. Yeah, that's what that song is about, okay? I might already get copyright whatever tagged by YouTube because I played LTD, Love Ballad. So I won't play the song, but congratulations. Look up that song, listen to that song. I believe that someone saying congratulations, but they missed out, okay? And that's the one, again, who fell off the wagon. Who was supposed to be your divine masculine or divine feminine, if that's your situation. But they didn't cut it, okay? They didn't want to do the work. So let them go. Again, don't be a hoarder. Spiritually, don't be a hoarder, okay? So thank you so much, as always, for tuning in. My name is Nehru. This is Esoteric Guidance. Anything else? Highest Divine White Light? Esoteric Guidance, and we are here. I am here. This lifetime, it's my 10th and final lifetime here to help us all become our highest, purest, truest form. Okay. On the bottom, we have 0404. It says, slow down. Did we not just have this steady energy coming in of the Knight of Cups? Okay. See how steady this energy is? And it's consistent, just steady, consistent energy. Slow down. There's no rush. Highest Divine White Light has promised it to us. Okay? So it is ours for the receiving, not the taking. It is ours for the receiving. Receive it. Okay? Allow the universe to do what the universe wants to do. Okay? Again, controlling what you can control and recognizing what you can't control. Okay? You do your part, universe will take care of the rest. And the waste. Right? You do your part, the universe will do theirs. Okay? You need to remove the trash out of your house, i.e. karmic energy. People, relationships, it doesn't matter. It could be your parents that's karmic relationship. If they are the ones who are keeping you from your divine masculine or feminine, okay? You need to remove them out of your life or from your selection process. Okay? Don't let them talk you into going to law school when you know you wanted to be a musician. Don't let them talk you into that. Don't let them talk you into that. And that's a metaphor. It might be literal for some, but don't let them talk you into that. No. No. You better go get that cello. You better go get that piano. You better go get that whatever. You better go get it. Okay? Hobo, which might have a different meaning. You better go get it. Okay? Do not let anybody talk you out of what is divinely promised to you. This journey has been long. It has been tedious. You've been faithful. Don't let anybody talk you out of what is promised to you. Don't let them. Okay? Don't let them. That's a lot. Okay. Compassion. So we are in mercy, diplomacy, potential, service, recovery, adaptability. That's extremely... Ooh. There's something with adaptability. Oh, man. Bring it back, ancestors. Highest divine white light. There is something... I often speak about being as water. But there's something about being adaptive. There's something about adaptable. There's something about that. There's something about that. Okay? There's something about that. So even with your divine masculine or divine feminine, wow, I'm approaching an hour. With your divine masculine or your divine feminine, there might be something that's not ideal about them. That, so for instance, okay? You might want someone who's 6'2". Your divine masculine coming in might be 5'11". Okay? You might have been hoping for a certain nationality, a certain skin color, whatever. Okay? If they're not, again, adaptable. Be adaptable. Okay? Do you want to miss out on your divine union because of a skin color? How naive and dumb. How stupid. Okay? How dumb. Okay? I believe, and I'm going to use myself as an example. Confirmation. So, that was a big one. So, I've believed, based on the images again and visions that I've seen, that my divine masculine is closer to this color than this color. Okay? If she turns out to be this color, I'm not gonna care. That doesn't matter to me, really. As long as she's not one of them crazy ass power to the black people, then she would never be that, because that's low vibrational energy. So let me just clear that out. Return to sender. Like, let me just clear that out right away. She would not be that, because I would not entertain that. Again, I don't support race-focused organizations, NAACP, Black Entrepreneurs of America, people that are brown, that people jump on their bandwagon just because. I am anti-Oprah Winfrey. Why am I anti-Oprah Winfrey? First of all, for a couple of reasons. One is because she talks about shit that she doesn't know about. She tries to tell you how to raise your child. Oprah couldn't tell you how to do shit with a child because Oprah doesn't have any children. Okay? All she can do is what a doctor does, and that's reiterate to you what a book says or what some other person says. That's all she can do. She has no experience as a parent. Okay? Also, when it's discovered that she and her connection with Epstein was running a sex trafficking ring with her school in Africa, it's going to blow up the universe. In regard energetically, okay, it's going to disappoint the billions of people who watched her for 25 years give them advice on how to live life. When that tower comes falling down, it's gonna be ugly when that happens. Mark this video, mark my words. When that happens, it's gonna be ugly. Okay, It's going to be ugly. All the people out there supporting Diddy and all that bullshit is going to be ugly. Supporting Will Smith, Jada Pinkett, liking their whatevers and subscribing to whatever they do. I'm telling you. Divine White Light is not happy. Is not happy about those situations and those false people. No more than he's happy about Creflo Dollar, Kenneth Copeland, Gwen Shamling, James Cleveland, Zachary Timms. Okay? So thank you so much, as always, for tuning in. Again, this is Esoteric Guidance. My name is Nehru, here to help us all become our highest, purest, truest version of ourselves in every aspect of our life. Okay? Thank you, as always, and be encouraged.